journey toward getting to know divinity was to enter into history. The question was it better to leave your allegiance to divine order and your need to have things explained in human logical fashion? The biggest conflict people have with God is that they expect God to behave like a human being. To have that some level of human order to us. When we began the journey of consciousness, I was in consciousness in the 1960s. When we began this exploration of the self, of what were we actually doing? Because we are now living in a culture that is completely immersed what does that in mysticism. Like in we could say that mysticism has gone mainstream. Right. And when I look at the types of struggles people are enduring in their lives, if I could only I recognize that I need a therapist, they need a spiritual director.
Have any of you said that prayer?
And that we turn to God and you expect a logical and spiritual answer. You expect God to say it's happening because. And you think your whole life is going to be better if this mystery were answered. What if you ask if I were to say what if mystery exists? I want to answer to your question. I would say the first thing I want to say to you.
The journey toward getting to know God was to enter into...
What do you expect your guidance to sound like? What type of guidance have you been looking for? What are you expecting to hear from God? And then I would send you home and tell you to do that as 100%. I would tell you to empty yourself of thoughts in exactly those areas. What are you expecting to hear from God?
This is not easy.
And you would empty yourself.
When we began
the
journey of consciousness, I was in consciousness in the 1960s.
As part of a spiritual program.
When we began this exploration of the self,
what am I expecting of God? Now, simultaneously, I want to take you in a culture
of your close
what
friends,
happens
but
here
in
life, in what has to happen in your mysticism, that also sets the foundation for madness to strength. When you begin to ask what mystical questions, God talk to me clearly. God, take away distractions. God, let me know why I'm on this planet. You change the rules of your own life, and you change the rhythm of your life. What becomes necessary is the first stage, which is separation. You have to become separated from the world that you know. The first stage is separation. And when you enter separation, it can take you out of your job, it can take you out of your marriage, it can take you out of your family. It can take you out of, and it will take you out of the familiar life that you know. Why is that necessary? Because what you are actually doing is you're saying, I want every voice that detracts from the clear one to be taken away from me. What you're actually praying when you pray for spiritual union is to get every little one of your being to know God that distracts you.
want to take donors, but how can I spend what happened to me in your ordinary life? What has to happen in your ordinary life? Do you understand? You're not going to say, okay, I know I'm going to sit here and wait for spiritual FedEx. I'm expecting an important letter. You just expect it to happen. You have to live this. God told